Hi guys, Dr. Laurie Cestnick here with Mind Matters. Today we're talking about study skills and how to get good grades.
Audio jungle.
There are traits of people who get good grades that are pretty common, and those traits don't exist as much in those who don't get good grades. Those traits are not intellect or hard work like we might think, but instead, they are self-motivation, self-discipline, and resilience. Self-motivation, self-discipline, and resilience. So we want to exercise those abilities in order to get good grades. Those are traits that help us get good grades. Another thing that separates those who get good grades from those who do not is how they set up their day planner. And specifically, writing in things in their day planner that they love to do. In fact, people who get good grades, one of the first things they do in their day planner is they write in all those fun things that they actually want to do. So for me, that might include mountain biking or kayaking. For someone else, it might be as simple as hanging with your friends or playing with your dog. But don't forget to feed your soul. Don't forget to do the things that you love. And when you do the things that you love, you will naturally be more motivated and naturally have more self-discipline and be more resilient because you're just happier and more able to do that. So don't forget to plan in your fun in your day plan. The next thing that's important to getting good grades is learning how to study itself. So we're going to talk about how to improve your memory for the information that you are learning and the recall of the information that you are learning. Review your notes often. The best way to review your notes is to write down everything that you remember from class. Don't worry if it's a very small amount. Just write out what you remember from class. Then cross-check that with your actual notes, make note of the things that you forgot, and then you want to focus on those things and trying to remember those things. Whenever it comes time to reviewing your notes, which should be at least every couple days or so, you want to implement this same method. Write out what you remember and then cross-check it for accuracy and then work on the things that you have forgotten or didn't understand very well. During this process, you want to demystify abstract concepts, okay? Demystify abstract concepts. What that means is you want to take words that are complex or phrases or ideas that are complex and give yourself some very real world examples of what that means and what that means to you so that you can recall that information better and understand that information better. Okay, now when it comes to really recalling everything that you need to know for a test and being able to answer complex questions about that material, right? So basically you want to rock the test. You want to do your best. The best way to do this is to take everything that needs to be learned for that test and to categorize that information into three headings. You need to decide what those three headings are. Maybe for history, it might be the 1800s, the 1900s, and the millennium. I don't know. Maybe with math, it might be geometry, algebra, and calculus. Who knows, right? But you want to think about how you want to divide the information into three topics. Then under each of those three topics, I want you to have three more topics. And then under each of those, I want you to have three more. And so on until you have a tree diagram that is going to encompass all of that information in a way that you have organized that allows you to recall all of it. Why do this? Because working memory can only process so much information at one time. By categorizing your information into threes, you are ensuring that you can recall at least three things at a time. You will always know you can recall three, and then another three, and then another three, and then another three, to be able to recall all of the information that you have categorized on your paper. Also, as you're going through this process, it's forcing you to really see how information is related to each other, which is forcing you to assimilate the knowledge with each other and into existing memories within your brain. Now, if you want to take this even further, what you want to do is you want to take some words from far right on the page and maybe grab a couple from the middle and at the end and come up with questions that integrate those things, maybe three things. Come up with a question that could possibly be on an exam integrating those three things. In fact, pull words randomly from your tree diagram and come up with questions and answer them. That, you know, this is going to really allow you to know your material and think about it in different ways and solidify your memory and your recall of information. In fact, these tree diagrams allow people with very, very limited working memory, and people who've been in car accidents and had concussions, their working memory can become very, very weak for a while, and people who have extremely weak working memory can actually learn entire textbooks with this method of this tree diagram method that I'm telling you about. Finally, for today, just know this simple fact that how you study and learn the information needs to be similar to how it is going to be retrieved. If you're going to be handwriting things out in written form on paper, you want to write the answers out on paper as you're studying. If the room is going to be cold, make your room cold. If you're going to be sitting at a hard desk, sit at a hard desk. Recall that the more similar the conditions between studying and test writing, the more information you're going to be able to recall later. That's just 5 minutes on studying. We can do another one another time. But anyway, for now, write to me if you have any other questions. This will do for now. I'm Dr. Laurie Cestnick for Mind Matters, and we'll see you next time. I was studying and how to get good grades. Write to me if you have any questions. Blah, 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 blah.